Hello students, now it's time for examination. As we are going to start with the periodic test examination in our school, there are few guidelines I want you all to go through. Okay, now the very important part of examination is your question papers. So the moment you get your question papers, what all things you should keep in mind? First of all, read all the instructions given in the paper. Once you read the paper, once you read the instructions, go through the questions which are given in the question paper. Read those questions. As the allotted time will be given to you for reading, read the question paper thoroughly. If you have any doubt, you need to ask me through the WhatsApp. Okay, you can call through the WhatsApp and ask us doubt also. Doubt not in the questions, only if the question is not visible. Okay, shall we start? So the moment you get the question paper in your hand and when you write the answers, many times you tell, ma'am, we have written the answer but we have got less marks. So what all things a teacher expects from you while writing an answer paper? So the moment you get your question paper, first read, go section wise. So you need to write section A first. In section A, you have first question, that is very short answer type questions. For example, now first question given to you is, whom do you call autotrophs and heterotrophs? Now in this, autotroph and heterotroph both are asked. So you have to write the answer and you will get half marks for each. You can give example also. So the mode of nutrition in which organisms make food themselves is called as autotroph. Example is plants. Animals and most other organisms take in ready-made food prepared by the plants, and therefore they are called as heterotrophs. If you write both the points, you get half and half. So understood? Next question is, mention some several breeds of sheep that are found in different parts of our country. Now here you have to write the different breeds what you find in different parts of our country. So here I have given with the country name, that is optional, that if you want to write, you can write. Now, how many breeds you have to write? So it is for 1 mark. It means it is understood that for 1 mark, how many breeds you should write? 2. Half each. Okay? What do you call a mutually beneficial relationship between two living organisms? Answer expected is symbiosis. And if you write the correct with the statement, you have to write not only one word, with a whole sentence you have to write. That is, then you will get 1 mark. Next question, what determines the direction of flow of heat between the objects in contact? So you have to write what determines. Understand the question, what determines. So what is that factor which determines the flow of heat between the two objects in contact? So the factor is the temperature, the difference in temperature. One has to be cold, one will be hot. Correct? So the difference in temperature of the body determines the direction of the flow of heat. That is the first half marks. Now how it travels? It travels from a higher temperature to a lower temperature. Then you get 1 mark. Okay. So answering is also a technique. You need to answer very, very smartly. Next is, which is the fastest method of heat transfer? So out of conduction, convection and radiation. First you identify which is the fastest method. So that is the answer is radiation. And how it is and why it is, that you have to define. So half marks for the word radiation and half marks for the explanation. Understood? Now this I will be sharing with in the Google Classroom. You can go through the all the answers in the Google Classroom. Next is multiple choice questions. Second part of section A, that is multiple choice questions. Now when you read the multiple choice questions, so plant traps insect because it is a heterotroph, grows in soil which lacks in nitrogen, does not have chlorophyll, has a digestive system like human beings. Now when you read the multiple choice question, you don't have to waste your time in finding the options. First is you be clear with your answer. If you have your answer in your mind and then you go through the options, just see what answer you have in your mind. Is it there in the option or no? If it is there, then select the B and then the statement. You have to write in the answers. Which of the following does not yield wool? Out of this 4, woolly dog. handles of cooking utensils should be made of material that does not conduct heat well. Okay, so with this we finish section A. Let's go to section B, which are short answer type questions. Give scientific reasons. Now here you have to give the reason, and each of the reason carries 1 mark. So an ordinary glass bottle cracks when boiling water is poured into it, but a Borosil glass bottle does not. So ordinary glass. Okay, in the labs when we use a Borosil glass bottle. Why it does not break when it is also made of glass? Why the ordinary glass breaks? Because normal glass is an insulator, which means it is a poor conductor of heat. When boiling water is poured into the glass tumbler, so when you write the insulator word, first you have to, because this is a chapter of heat, so whatever examples we are going to give, the specific word we expect is an insulator conductor. Okay, so normal glass is an insulator, which means a poor conductor of heat. Now you explain it. When boiling water is poured into the glass tumbler, the surface of the glass which is in contact with the hot water heats up and expands, but the outer layer of the glass remains cold and does not expand, since glass is a poor conductor and does not transfer heat quickly. So this difference is called as thermal expansion, causes the thermal stress which eventually leads to cracking. Now we don't expect you to write everything very correctly, but it has to be correct, justification has to be given. So the answer which we expected is this insulator, and then why it is not occurring in the Borosil. Okay, normal glass is an insulator, it will not conduct heat, so it breaks. Okay. Second, the telephone wires which sag in summer become straight in winter, because in summer the surrounding temperature is very high. So with respect to temperature, so the main word is here is temperature. Then the temperature is high or low, inside or outside. These are the common terms you should be utilizing to answer. Okay, so when you give it, the correct word is temperature, high or low, that you have to explain it with your answer. Then you get 1 mark. Next is dewdrops form on the grass in winter. Again, the temperature comes here, cold and hot. Okay, you need to give the answer with terms of hotness and coldness. And if you give it, that becomes your 1 mark. So that is the temperature. You cannot write pressure here. Okay. Next, 10th A question. Now there are various questions. Now first question was 1 marks. Next 10th A question, you will be having A part and B part. A part has 2 marks. Make sketches of the 2 stages in the life history of the silkworm. Now sketches doesn't mean the sketch I want. I want the points. Okay. So here is, make the sketches of the 2 stages in the life history of the silk moth, which are directly related to the production of silk. So which are the 2 stages? The caterpillar makes a cocoon of silk threads around itself little by little and cover itself completely, 1 mark. Then the caterpillar changed into pupa. So pupa stage. This is when the silk threads are obtained for the production of silver silk fibers. So both the 2 stages, 2 marks you get. Next is, name the following method for removing the fleece from the body of animals. Correct, if you write shearing, that is 1/2 mark, and then twisting of fibers into yarns, spinning, that is 1/2 mark. So here you get 2 plus 1/2 and 1/2 is 1, that is 3